my god, this was such a highly requested video from you guys. So here I am giving my thoughts on the new brand Be Minimalist. So stay tuned till the end to know everything that you need to know about this new brand called Be Minimalist, and going in depth about the controversy and content creator bashing this brand, to popular Instagram channels even calling this a blatant plagiarism, and also a detailed review of one of their products, that is the kojic acid 2% and alpha arbutin 1%. Hey guys, if you are seeing this face for the very first time, hi, I'm Moitri Haldar. I post a lot of skincare videos such as this one, makeup videos, haul videos, recipe videos, random videos, and everything that you guys will recommend me, such as this video right here. So if you are into that genre, then do consider subscribing and hitting on that bell notification for you to get notified every time I upload, which is Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays. So before talking about the product, I'm going to talk about the brand. Now this brand is relatively new. I think it launched about like 1.5 or 2 weeks ago, and I placed my order on the day it launched. Now some of you guys told me about this new brand. So the main agenda of this brand is to be transparent about their sources, their formulation, what are the ingredients. And one of the reasons that I really like this brand is because it is focused upon teaching or educating the consumers what are the ingredients, and to get consumers into reading ingredient lists and what exactly what ingredient does. Now this brand is formulated without fragrance and essential oils, silicones, dyes, parabens, and sulfate. You already get a gist of how the brand is going to be. This brand has a total of 10 products currently, and all of the products are like serum and peel based, but they are formulating toners, which they updated in their Instagram handle. And I'll mention everything about the brand, about the Instagram handle, about their website, about where I got my product, which is from Amazon. I'll mention everything on the bottom box below, so check it. I was really intrigued to buy their kojic acid because I love kojic acid. So I chose this product, which is a kojic acid 2% and alpha arbutin 1%. Coming to the claims of this product, now the claims in general of this brand is very to the point and very minimalist. And the claim of this product is to reduce your dark spots and pigmentation, which the kojic acid and alpha arbutin combo surely does. So coming to the main juice of my reviews, which is the ingredient list or the composition. And if you like this ingredient focused reviews, then I'll highly suggest you guys to watch this playlist right here, which has a lot of reviews, including some popular reviews, and some of the products might burst your myths but the influencers gave you. So coming on to the ingredient list, as always I'll mention the goods and the bads. Now I do not have any bads for this ingredient list, so I'll only mention the goods. It contains aloe vera juice instead of water, and the really beneficial thing that the substitution of aloe vera juice to water does is that water sometimes can be dehydrating and it can be evaporated in the air, but aloe vera, as being the natural humectant, not only gives you moisture but also retains the water loss. So I'm really happy about the brand not including water and going straight ahead with the aloe vera juice. And let me tell you guys, aloe vera juice is the first ingredient, is most commonly in expensive product, so this being an affordable one, I'm really impressed. So the main focus of the serum is kojic acid, and it is their third ingredient. Now before diving into the other components of the ingredient list, I'm going to mention some of the benefits that the kojic acid does. Kojic acid is really beneficial because it inhibits L-tyrosine production, which is a type of amino acid needed for melanin synthesis. Melanin is basically the pigment that we have in our skin, and kojic acid is most commonly produced by fungus or fungi. And also kojic acid is seen in like fermented stuff such as sake, which is Japanese rice wine, soy milk, and even soy sauce. Now the percentage of kojic acid really matters because kojic acid is really potent, and the ideal potency of kojic acid should be less than 4%, and it is ideally kept at 1% to 2% for the major part of the audience, because if you go above that, then the kojic acid might sensitize your skin too much. Now this brand chose a really good kojic acid, and that is the kojic depalmitate, and this ingredient right here is really efficient and also not that sensitizing, and can be used till 5% without any irritation or any sensitizing to even the sensitive skin genre. It also contains alpha arbutin, and alpha arbutin is known to exhibit the antioxidant ability and also to break down hydroquinone. Hydroquinone is basically a substance that is present inside our cells, which limit the excretion of melanin. So both kojic acid and alpha arbutin are limiting our melanin production. So the combination of two does really great in hyperpigmentation or pigmentation to be in general, such as acne marks, hyperpigmentation around our mouth, or like post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation. So if you have any pigmentation related concern, kojic acid and alpha arbutin has to be in your skincare. And if you want to learn how you can fade your pigmentation and your acne scars, I have made a video dedicated to that. So apart from kojic acid and alpha arbutin, it has amazing humectant, including aloe vera juice, and also very good emollients, which will not only hydrate your skin but also moisturize your skin. It also has very good preservative, and not a single preservative is known to sensitize your skin. So it's perfect for the sensitive skin, even the dry skin, and also everything in between. And lastly, it contains an ingredient called pululan. Now pululan is an ingredient which gives you this tightening feeling, and this ingredient is really popular in anti-aging products, and it is also an antioxidant, and it is again produced by fungus or fungi. Now coming to some of the specification of the product, going straight ahead with the texture itself. Now the texture of this product is really nice. It has the silky feeling that the silicone rich product has, but it doesn't contain any silicone. So I'm guessing the aloe vera juice is responsible for that feeling, and I'm really liking it. It also absorbs really quickly, and this product right here has a slightly sticky feeling, but it is generally common in humectant rich product, because there is a theory in Korean skincare that after applying your skincare, if your skin is a little bit sticky, that means your product is absorbed nicely in your skin. So I'm not exactly mad about that. Even if you have an oily skin, it would suit you perfectly. It is an oil-free formula, so it can basically suit all skin types. Potency-wise, it's a pretty beginner-friendly serum, and the kojic acid percentage is 2% and the alpha arbutin is 1%. So to the mass amount of audience, it won't sensitize your skin. It didn't for me, but if you are from a sensitive skin background, please patch test and then use it. Packaging wise, it comes in a glass bottle with a dropper, and it is a transparent bottle. I would have really liked if the company started giving tinted bottles for their serums, because the product remains consistent throughout the shelf life. This has a shelf life of about 6 months. Now coming to the price range, I'm really happy about that. It comes under the budget of 500 to 600 rupees. For 30 ml, you pay about 549 rupees. You can get a little bit cheaper in their website, but you do have to pay shipping in their website for a certain amount. Now coming to the application, it is a normal serum, but it is a really humectant based serum, and in fact, it doesn't use any water. So to extract all the benefits from this serum, you can apply it on a damp skin. Just apply the serum on a damp skin and then quickly top it off with a moisturizer of your preference, and that will just seal all the moisture. And as it is an active rich serum, it can sensitize your skin to photo damage. So please apply an SPF whenever you are stepping out, or even you are in your home, just apply an SPF throughout the day. Your skin will thank you, and this can be used in both day and night. Now coming to the controversy, yes, I do feel it is kind of a similar product as Ordinary compared to the packaging, but many of the brands are doing this, and to be honest, Ordinary doesn't have same products such as this one. I think Ordinary has alpha arbutin, but it doesn't have kojic acid in it. But what I really like about this brand is that they came clean and they told why they chose this design and what did really happen. So I'm really happy about that, that they are listening to consumers. And in fact, Minimalist gave their word in changing their product packaging and shipping it in next 2 to 3 weeks. So hopefully after 2 to 3 weeks, you will get a brand new packaging from Minimalist. That just shows how better of a brand it is. Now popular brands such as Nykaa and Dot & Key are already doing it. Nykaa being blatantly copying anything and everything putting out on their face, such as the eyeshadow palettes, the lipsticks, in fact the facial oils. Everything is kind of a copied or inspired, as they might say. And also Dot & Key blatantly copying the packaging of Frutia, not mentioning anything publicly. And I would highly suggest you guys, please do not compare those brands to Minimalist, because not only they address the issue of the copy of packaging and so-called plagiarism as told by this diet Sabia. I do not know who she or he is, but apparently she is famous. But what matters to me is the ingredient list. And let me tell you guys, this is one of the best ingredient lists that I have found in India. If they change their packaging, I will be one of their faithful customers. I really like their ingredient list, and this should be the main focus, not the plagiarism, not the controversy. And PS, after they change their packaging, I will be bringing more and more Minimalist reviews. That was all the controversy, right? So coming on to my thoughts, I absolutely love this product. The reason of me doing a quick review, because I have used this product for only 1 week or 1.5 week, because I have seen a result so fast. I really wanted to share this, because normally with any skincare product, I generally take about 2 to 4 weeks to try the product and to test the product. But with this product, many of you guys were requesting, and I thought of doing this review because I have seen a visible result. Now you might not believe me, so I have done this result kind of a thing. You can see the before and after. So quickly, I'll mention some pros and cons. Now pros being, it contains aloe vera instead of water. It contains alpha arbutin and kojic acid, which is really beneficial for your hyperpigmentation and pigmentation. It is also fragrance and essential oil free. It is also an Indian brand. It is also a very humectant and emollient based serum. It contains very good ingredient list. Not a single bad thing I need to say about this product. That is one of the biggest pros, by the way. And lastly, it's a very beginner friendly product. So coming on to the cons, the only single con I have with this product, or the brand to be in general, is that I think this brand should come up with tinted bottles. It's my preference. I like my products to be in a tinted bottle, because not only it increases the shelf life, but also the stability of the product. Now coming to my verdict, I would absolutely recommend this product to anyone looking for a cure to their hyperpigmentation. Not exactly a cure, but a great additive to your skincare routine to improve all the hyperpigmentation, the pigmentation, the PIH, the post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation or acne scars, anything related to pigmentation or darkening your skin, this product might be really beneficial to you. This brand also has some great products, such as the niacinamide serum that I'm going to buy soon, and the apple cider vinegar one, which I'm really intrigued, and I will buy that soon too. And PS, this is not a paid promotion either. They sent me the product. I have bought this from my own money, and I'm absolutely loving this product. So hey guys, that was my video on this Be Minimalist and their controversy and this amazing product right here. So if you guys like my reviews, do like this video, comment down below any other product that you guys want me to try and then post a review, and also your thoughts on this brand and the controversy. Share this video to any of your friend who is judging this brand and want to see a unfiltered review which is not shading this brand. Subscribe to my channel for getting more such content, and I'll see you guys in my next video. So bye bye and take care.